Financial planning has come a long way since the first time I heard about it. It was probably in the early 2000s. 2004 is when I wrote my CFP exam, Certified Financial Planner exam, and I qualified in the first batch of CFPs in India. And at that stage, we were all trying to figure out from one another that what is the right sort of format of a plan, what are the ingredients of a plan. So we had learned the theoretical parts of it, but I think over the last 14, 15 years, what has really, really helped is the number of clients for whom we have done financial plans. I started personally with a two-page financial plan for clients in 2005. We used to charge a fee for the plan. And I know that, we hardly sort of scratch the surface. Today, the financial plan sort of encompasses not just your financial goals, your investments, your risk cover, but it also takes into account your asset allocation across different countries, currencies, between physical assets and financial assets, between assets which are liquid, which are not. And also the whole aspect of passing on your assets, so estate planning. Today, I think a lot of people have family members who are spread in different countries, and therefore looking at the tax requirements, the reporting requirements, looking at the impact of currency movements, a lot of this needs to be taken into account when doing the plan. I think financial planning has really come to stay, and we have seen quite a few examples of clients who have benefited from the plan. One particular client I recall who did not have enough assets to meet all his financial goals, and we went through multiple iterations to see if there was anything that he could sacrifice in terms of goals. And when we finally agreed that these were absolutely must-haves in his financial plan, he went and spoke with his organization, tried to get an enhancement in his income and earning levels. And when he didn't, he actually moved from Mumbai to the Middle East because he needed to earn that extra money to meet the financial goals of his family. I think it is very important for each and every individual to get a financial plan done. And for those who have got the plan done, it is equally important to have a continuous review of the financial plan just to make sure that you are on track. Because along the way, goals might have changed, priorities might have changed, and things which are external to your area or sphere of control, like tax rates, like expected rates of return on certain products, inflation, regulation, a whole bunch of things would have changed around you. So it's a good idea and a good habit to review the financial plan that you have done. But before that, just make sure that each and every one of you does have a financial plan.